Hello, good day everyone. Once again, welcome back to my channel, and I believe everyone is doing good. I'm going to take you through how to use the coin market app, how to use the coin market app to purchase a coin, how to analyze a coin on the coin market app before you purchase it on a trust wallet or before you purchase it on any exchange. So that is what I'm going to take you through today. So what you do is that before you can use the coin market app, you need to have it on your phone. Yes, so as I have it here on my phone. If you don't have the coin market app, you can just go to the Google Play Store and then you search for coin market app. Coin market app. So coin market cap. This is it. I click on it and then it takes me to the coin market app. Since I have it on my phone, you see it has the open here. So once you have it on your phone, you can go away and then you open it from here. But if you don't have it, you can download it from the Play Store, Google Play Store, or the App Store. So once you have installed the coin market app on your phone, what you do is that you click on the coin market app and then it takes you straight away to the homepage of the coin market app. So this is how the homepage looks like. This is the homepage of the coin market app. So I'm going to take you through a few sections of the coin market app, the most important parts, and then for the rest of the part you can navigate through yourself. So the purpose here is to learn how to purchase a coin using the contract address of the coin. So how do you get a contract address of a coin? All right, so once you are on the home page of the coin market app, you use the search button on the upper right corner of the screen. Yeah, so you click on the search button. Once you click on the search button, it gives you access to trending coins, the coin that is trending. So you can see the trending. These are the coins that are trending on coin market app. These are different coins that are trending on the coin market app based on ranking. And then if you come down here, you see top movers. Top movers means that coins that have increased in values within the last 1 hour. So you see, you can check the last 1 hour from here. Coins that are top movers. And then within the last 24 hours, coins that are moving the markets. And then you can also check the last 7 days also from here. So that is how to check the top movers. And then outside the top movers, we have, you can search for different coins. So what you do is that you just type in the name of the coin you are searching for. For example, I'm looking for BTC. I just type BTC, Bitcoin. You just type Bitcoin and then it takes you to the Bitcoin section. Okay, so I said you click on the search button and then you search for the name of the coin. So BTC, you see Bitcoin has appeared here. We have Bitcoin, Bit2. It will give you categories of Bitcoin. So all that you have to do is to click on Bitcoin here and then it takes you to the overview of the page. Okay, and then it gives you the statistics and everything. So you would see that from here as well. But you know, Bitcoin is one of the popular coin. Okay, so I want us to use how do you get to know the contract address of a new coin, or probably someone has recommended a coin to you and you want to buy. So first of all, what you have to do is to come to the coin market app. Okay, you come to the coin market app and then for example, let me search for Luna. So this is the Luna coin. I'm going to use the Luna coin to demonstrate how you can get a contract address and then how you can purchase it on the trust wallet or how you can purchase it on an exchange. So I typed Luna on the search button and then it took me straight to the Luna coin. Okay, so all that I have to do is to click on the Luna coin. Once you click on the Luna coin, it will give you an overview of how the coin is performing. So this is an overview of how the coin is performing. You can see from here how the coin has increased in value in the last 24 hours, in the last 7 days. You can check the last 30 days also from here, just upper part of the candlestick. You can check the last 90 days, how the coin is doing, and then the last 1 year. You can also check it from here. Then you can check all time. Okay, you can check all time from here as well. So it depends on how you want to analyze the price or the chart of that particular coin you are looking for. So if you scroll downwards, you see statistics. So these are the statistics of the coin. You see the market cap here. You see the fully diluted market cap. You see the volume, the circulating supply, the maximum supply, the total supply, the all-time high. That is the highest price the coin has attained. And then you see the coin based on the ranking. So you see this coin on the ranking, it is 2677. It has been ranked the 2677th coin, okay? And then you see all-time low. The lowest price the coin has gone once it was launched. And then the market dominance. So the next thing is to scroll down. When you scroll down about Luna coin, you can click on see all and then read much about the Luna coin, and then you can explore and get a lot of info from here. Okay, so what you have to do is to go to, you see, you have to, if you want to see how the coin is performing, how people are talking about the coin, you have to follow the social address of the coin, or you have to go to their website. So what you do is to click on the links. Once you click on the link, it will take you to a page where you have access to their website, have access to their community. Okay. I have Shiba Inu, one of the most popular coin these days. Let me search for Shiba Inu using the search button. So I use the search button here. I click and then I search for Shiba Inu. So all right, so this is Shiba Inu. I click on Shiba Inu. And then once again, it takes me to the overview. Once I have talked about the overview, I would like to go down. I've talked about the statistics, the how to check the market cap and all of that. Then I scroll downwards. Okay, once I scroll downwards, I can read about Shiba Inu from here. If I don't have much info, I can read about the Shiba Inu from this section. If you click on see all, it would take you, give you a broad overview about Shiba Inu, their roadmap, and whatever they are doing is there. So you can see from here, now Shiba Inu is built on the Ethereum blockchain, okay? It's built on the Ethereum blockchain. So this is their contract address on the Ethereum blockchain. This is their contract address. So you can click on copy, and then the address will be copied successfully, okay? And then you can see another blockchain that is built on, that is the Kronos. You can also copy the contract address here. Now, when you copy the contract address on the Ethereum blockchain, you have to use Uniswap. You have to use Uniswap to go and swap the coin or to purchase the coin. So based on the blockchain that is built on and how you can purchase that. So before I end the video, I will demonstrate one to you how to use the Uniswap or the PancakeSwap once it's built on the Binance Smart Chain. Okay, so this is how to get a contract address. You see the contract address here, there are two, based on the blockchain that is built on. Then once again, you come to the links, you click on the website, you click on the link, and it takes you to this section where you can have access to all the social media parts, all the social media part of the coin. Okay, so with Telegram, just look at it below the screen. You see Telegram, you click on Telegram, and then it will take you to Telegram, the Shiba Inu Telegram group, okay, where you can have info as to what people are saying about the coin, as to their project, things that they are working on. You can see all of that on Telegram. So almost all the coins have their Telegram group. So that is how to join the Telegram group of a coin. I have not downloaded Telegram on this particular phone, but once you click on view in Telegram, it will take you to their Telegram, and then you join their group, and from there you can be following whatever they are talking about, whatever projects they are doing and all of that. You can see on their Telegram group, and then you can explore their Twitter page as well. Yes, it will take you to their Twitter handle and whatever they are talking about. Once again, I don't have the Twitter, I've not logged in on Twitter on this phone. So once you click on Twitter, it will take you to their Twitter handle. You can see their technical documentation. You can read their white sheet. It would all be on this section. That is when you click on the links. When you click on the links, and then you can explore the other section as well. So let's find a particular coin. Let's find a particular coin and then try to use the contract address. Okay, so if you look up here, we have the trending coin. We have this coin that is trending. It's on the number first. It's the number one on the trending list. That is 1FT. 1FT. So I'm going to use this coin. Let's click on 1FT. Once you click on 1FT, it gives you the charts, and then we scroll downwards. You can likewise, you can read about the coin, but this is the contract address. You see, this is built on the Binance Smart Chain, BIP20, Binance Smart Chain. So once it's built on the Binance Smart Chain, it means we can use PancakeSwap to swap the coin. So what you do is that you copy the contract address from here. Always when you scroll down the screen, you would see the contract address of the coin. So I just copy this contract address. I click on copy, and then the address will be successfully copied. Then what I do is that I go to my Trust Wallet. If you have not watched my video on how to use the Trust Wallet, you can explore my channel. You will find out to see how you can use the Trust Wallet. I've talked into detail about how you can use the Trust Wallet. So once you come here, you come to your Trust Wallet, you click on this two sign dots here, and then you paste the contract address of the coin here. So once you paste the contract address, the coin will automatically pop up. If it doesn't pop up, it means that the coin is not that most of the tokens are not on the Trust Wallet. So you have to add it manually. You have to add it manually. So if you want to add it manually, you click on add custom token. Add custom token. Once you click on add custom token, it will take you to this page. Then where you have the network, because this coin is built on the Binance Smart Chain, you change it from Ethereum to Binance Smart Chain. You change it to Smart Chain. Okay, so once you change it to Smart Chain, you click on where we have the contract address, and then you paste the contract address here. You paste the contract address here. Once you paste the contract address, it gives you the name of the coin, the symbol, and then the decimals. Okay, then you click done. Once you click done, the coin has been added to your Trust Wallet. The coin has been automatically being added to your Trust Wallet. So you can see from here the price of the coin and the percentage change here from the screen. Okay, so once I go back to my Trust Wallet, you could see that the coin has been added on my Trust Wallet. Just look at the lower part of the screen, you see the coin here. So that is how to do that. Let's pick another coin once again and try to see. Okay, so like I said, if you click the links, also it will take you to the social media handles of the coin. You can see their Twitter from here, their Telegram, their website, and everything. Okay, so it is very important to join their social media platform so that you can see whatever there is going on. So like I said, when someone recommended a coin for you, or if you come across any coin and you want to buy, the first place to search for is the coin market app. You can find a coin on the coin market cap. Sure. So the I want to talk about this coin. Let me see. Ethereum Flocky Inu. Let me see Flocky Inu. Flocky Inu. All right. So once I type that on the search button, it gives me the name of the coin. I click on it. I click on Flocky Inu, and then it takes me to this page. This is the chart of the Flocky Inu. You could see that the coin has really rise from here. It has really rise from here, and it's going up. Okay. Yes. So someone recommended this coin to me some few days ago. And then once I came here, I searched for the coin. I look at the statistics, and I will definitely do a video on things that you must check up. When someone recommends a coin for you, you don't have to just go and purchase it. You have to analyze the coin and look at where you have to buy the coin. Okay, definitely you have to see the support and the resistance. You have to analyze it carefully before you can buy that particular coin. So once I scroll down, okay, so it takes me to where I can see the contract address. So this is the contract address on the Ethereum blockchain, and then this is the contract address on the Binance Smart Chain. So it means that Flocky Inu, this coin I'm talking about, it's been listed or it's been built on two blockchains. It is on the Ethereum blockchain, which means that you can use the PancakeSwap to buy or purchase the coin. And then you can also use the Binance Smart Chain, once it's also built on the Binance Smart Chain, to purchase the coin. So if you are using a Uniswap to purchase the coin, just use the Ethereum contract address. So I click on it, and then it will be copied. Okay, if I want to use the PancakeSwap to purchase the coin, I'll have to click on the contract address of the smart chain. Okay, so in this case, I just have to copy the contract address. Once I copy the contract address, I go to my Trust Wallet to search for the coin. So once I come to my Trust Wallet, I use this search button, and then I paste the contract address here. Very good. It will automatically give me the coin. Okay. So I just have to check it so that it would appear on my coin list, on the list or the homepage of the Trust Wallet. Okay. So like I said, if you paste the contract address and you don't find a coin here, you can add custom token. I just demonstrated that a few minutes ago. You add a custom token. Okay. So that is how to search for the contract address of a coin, and then you purchase it on the Trust Wallet. So in my next video, I'm going to show you how to use the contract address. Once you have added it to your Trust Wallet, what do you do next? You go to dApps, and then you come to PancakeSwap. I'm going to demonstrate that in my next video. I don't want this video to be boring and long, so I would have to cut it short. And in my next video, I'll show you how to use the Uniswap and the PancakeSwap to purchase a particular token. Okay, so once the token is not listed on an exchange, you can use Uniswap or PancakeSwap, or you can buy it from their website straight away. So I'll be demonstrating that in my next video that I'll be sharing with you. I want to go back to the coin market cap and talk about a few things you must also know on the coin market cap, and then I would end this section. Okay, so on the coin market app, we have some other things I need to talk about. We have the price alerts. When you click on the price alert, you can add the price alert of a particular coin. If you want to buy a coin and you think you have analyzed the coin and you want to buy it at a certain price, you can come here and add. Maybe I want to buy Bitcoin. Okay, so on the price alert, I look at I just set a price alert here that when Bitcoin reaches $45,000, okay, I want to buy some. Okay, currently look at the price of Bitcoin is around $50,989. So I set a price target that maybe when Bitcoin drops to 45,000, I would buy some. So I just set 45,000 as my price alert. Then I set the price. So once Bitcoin gets to 45,000, CoinMarketApp would automatically alert me with a pop-up notification message that Bitcoin is at $45,000. Then once it's there, I can just go straight away and then purchase some on any exchange or on the Trust Wallet or whichever place you want to purchase. So that is how to add an alert. You can add alerts of many different coins you want to. You can add as many as you want. Okay, so that's how to use the price alert section. And you have also you can also compare here. You can compare different coins here. You see BTC versus Litecoin here. You can explore through that yourself. And then we have the converts. You can convert if you want to know how much Bitcoin will cost in a different coin or how much a different coin will be cost in a different coin. You can use the convert section, which will be very useful for you. Probably you want to buy what you want to know how much maybe $50, $50 dollars will cost in BTC or would cost in BNB or whichever coin. Okay, you can use the convert section to do that. And we have watch list. Now with the watch list, when you add any coin on your watch list, these are different coins I've added on my watch list. When you add any coin on your watch list, okay, when the coin increase in value by a percentage, certain amount of percentage, or it decrease in value by a certain amount of percentage, CoinMarketApp will give you a notification message that this coin has increased by 20% in the last 1 hour. This coin has increased by maybe 30% in the last 24 hours. It will keep giving you that alert once you have added that coin or token on your watch list. So that is how to go about that. And we also have the top coins, how the popular coins. Okay, so Bitcoin is the first, Ethereum, we have Binance Coin, we have Theta, we have the Solana, we have Cardano. Okay, so you can find all the top coins from here. You can click on see all, and then it will give you the list of all the top coins here. Then the next thing is to come gainers and losers. Gainers and losers. By gainers and losers, we mean coins that have increased in value and coins that have decreased in value based on a certain time frame. Okay, so I click on see all. Once I click on see all, this section is the gainers. Okay, so from here you could see coins that have gained in value. Okay, coins that have gained in value, they are listed here. And then when you drag this side to losers, okay, coins that have lost in value, top losers. So based on rank, you could see top losers in the 20 last 24 hours, top losers in the last 1 hour, top losers in the last 7 days. You can see all from here. Okay, you can explore through that, and then you could see all for yourself. So that is a brief summary about the CoinMarketApp. You can also read other news concerning cryptocurrencies and different coins from here, this section. So take your time and then explore through the CoinMarketCap. It's one of the best app you would like to use, or you'd want to use, or you would have to use once you are investing into cryptos and different coins and different projects. You have to be using the CoinMarketCap to your benefit, to your advantage. It's very useful. You need to have this app. So once you have it on your phone, take your time to read through, take your time to digest it, okay, so that you can have a preview of whatever that is going on. So like I said, I hope this video I hope you find this video beneficial. Once you find this video beneficial, just click on the like button and then check the subscription button as well. If you have not subscribed to my channel, I'm going to drop my next video, which will talk about how to analyze a coin using the candlesticks. You don't have to just buy a coin. You need to analyze and know a good price or where the coin is likely to drop to, and then from there you can buy. So subscribe to the channel and then click the notification bell, and then you can get access to my content. Thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the day and then have a wonderful day. So like I said, I'm going to do a video on how to use the contract address to purchase a coin, either on the Ethereum blockchain or on the Binance Smart Chain or on a different exchange. I'm going to do that in my next video. So don't miss out. Once you are subscribed, you will get access to this content. Thank you so much and have a lovely day.